Mark, I'm going to start up with you. Ray had overcome a lot of obstacles to be able to keep his brother with him at school. What obstacles did you have to overcome to finally get the film made?
Well, you know, the obstacles that we had to overcome to get this film made were many in that, you know, I initially set up the film and was lucky enough to get Ray's rights 14 years ago when the story happened back in 2006. I was at another studio at the time. We developed a screenplay and then just never got a green light on that movie. And I knew we had a great film in there and I told Ray he had to just be patient. And I didn't think it would take 14 years, but you know, we kept in touch over the years and I just said, Ray, I'm gonna get this movie made. So when Disney Plus announced that their venture was happening, and I'd made a lot of movies at Disney, and I felt like this one would be perfect for the platform. And we brought it over and was one of the first things that they bought. And again, everything's about timing. You know, I think back in 2006, I brought it by and I tried to get it at Disney at the time, and it was a different regime and it just didn't happen. So, you know, everything lined up now, and that's what happens when movies end up getting made. They just, there's an ease, and there's, you know, you get these lucky breaks and start to put things together. You know, we continue to work on the script, you know, brought in another writer, brought in Reggie, and then the cast part of it. And it was just amazing. Big team effort.
Mark, you've made a lot of sports themed movies. How is this one similar to the other films that you've produced, and how is it different?
You know, I think the big difference in this story is that it has diversity. And I think that's great, because now these fantastic stories have a better chance to reaching the screen. And that's amazing. You know, we put together, brought in an African-American writer, brought in Reggie to direct, you know, the cast, most of the crew too was African-American down in Atlanta. And I think that just helped with making the movie feel authentic. You know, I think it's the big kind of call word that you hear now. And I'm really proud to be, you know, a part of it. I'm really proud of all the films I've made, but this one's special. I've been with it a long time, and to be on this road and now have this story embraced, and we always knew that there'd be a big audience out there, and I think the platform's going to be positioned great. I mean, there's so many subscribers now, it's over 70 million. That's really exciting. When we set up the movie, there were zero. It hadn't even been launched, and in exactly a year it's 70 million. That's staggering. So I think there's going to be a great audience and a big audience for it, and really proud to bring it to people's homes.
Mark, why was Reginald Hudlin the perfect director for this film?
Well, I mean, I think if you look at his body of work, you know, it varies so much from comedy to dramatic, you know, films and documentaries. It just that's what I wanted to bring to this film, because there's humor, there's emotion, there's drama, there's just big moments. So, you know, you need somebody that are capable of kind of delivering all that. And I've just been a fan of his work, and we're really lucky to get him. You know, it's always hard. You know, you're in competition when directors are you know, in demand. So the material has to speak, and it's a lot to do with timing. So I think everyone was excited when he came in and put his hand up.